Ursula Mamlok, it is very fortunate that two of my Berlin friends, Isabel Hatzfeld and Habakkuk Traber, often suggested with rigor that Spectrum Concerts Berlin take an interest in your chamber music. As a result, February 1st, 2013, the day on which you became 90 years old, was chosen for a concert dedicated to some of your solo and chamber music. The evening was divided into three segments. The first dedicated solely to your music. The second included the Berlin premiere of your first string quartet and works by Janacek and Wolf, performed by the Armida Quartet. The third segment included Mendelssohn's string octet, performed as well by the Armida Quartet and members of Spectrum Concerts Berlin. Participating in bringing some of your musical life into the sphere of modern-day Berlin has been extremely fulfilling. This was your birthplace, which you were forced to abandon very early in your life. After many decades abroad, at first in Ecuador, and then the United States of America, you decided to return to Berlin, where you and your music have been received warmly. Can you speak a bit about your impressions that evening, February 1st, 2013, how it felt, how it sounded, and how it was to experience your music in this hall, the Philharmonie, closely woven into a program including music of others, such as Janacek, Wolf, and Mendelssohn?
Well, I can only see the whole idea of having so much music of mine on a large part of the program was certainly overwhelming. And I can tell you in so few words actually how it felt exactly, but it was a high point in my life, I can say. So that I not only am so happy to have had seven of my pieces performed, but to be with great composers like Mendelssohn, Janacek, and Wolf is certainly an honor for me. And I'm glad that you decided to have this combination.
Do you also find it much easier to make new music accessible to audiences today if it is combined with the works of composers from other eras?
Yes, I think that makes a difference. Also, the public that comes to the concert may come for my music, but also for the music of Mendelssohn and Wolf, and that makes a difference. When they hear that music, although this follows my music in this case, it makes my music in retrospect more accessible.
People often say, both those who are well-educated in the field of music, but also those who are not, I found very interesting, were commenting on how individual they found your style. How do you respond to that sort of a comment?
That is very interesting, because my style that you hear tonight came in late in my life. I first was trained as a tonal composer, and I have much music in that style. But I decided when I thought of being a 20th and 21st year born in the 20th century composer that I cannot compose like Brahms, much as I like him and Mozart. But I must have an individual style. It must be something new of that has to be created. I cannot imitate other people who compose today, and I don't want to do that. And so I suppose my style reflects that I have so much tonal music, but it has changed drastically, I think, knowing also the music of Schoenberg and of other more contemporary composers.
You've come back to Berlin in a late phase of your life.
Yes.
But you were in the thick of some amazing times in New York City.
Yes.
And in other parts of the USA.
Yes.
How does it feel to have come back to Berlin after so many years living in another country?
Well, yes, that's a good question, because it does feel somewhat strange, because Berlin has changed so much naturally The war has destroyed Berlin. The Berlin I knew was a different city than the Berlin I found when I returned.
Just before we begin to listen, can you just say a few, what, if I remember correctly, you were particularly happy that your first string quartet was going to be performed, and I believe it was the Berlin premiere that took place that evening, yes?
Yes.
Why is this, if it's true, is this piece particularly close to you?
This is because it was only the second piece in my new, so to speak, style. It is the most complex piece rhythmically, and to be performed is, of course, a great pleasure. It has been performed in New York and other cities, but to be performed here in Berlin is a special joy for me, because that piece, I think, is the most difficult, perhaps, for the listener. It's in three movements, and the last movement is a very quiet movement of one note, a one-note melody that goes into the four voices. So it's really a one-voice piece, the last piece is. And then it goes back to the beginning of the music as a big coda to reflect what I had done in this piece in the beginning.
We were all very lucky to have the great fortune of finding the Armida String Quartet to perform that for us.
I'm very lucky to have them, yes, because they played magnificently. And they were very attentive to rehearsal and already when we met, the piece was finished as far as the performance goes.
Tell me something very, very briefly about the piece 2,000 Notes.
2,000 Notes, as the letter says, was composed in the year 2000. And I found this sort of funny because I looked for a title and I said, oh, there's a title right there. It's 2,000 Notes. It has, of course, many more than 2,000 notes in the piece, but I thought it attractive to give it this title with the 2,000 in it.
Ursula, thank you very much, and let's listen.